Everyone, welcome back, and this is Naveen from UiBrains. So last class we have actually discussed about the Ajax with REST API. So in this video we are going to discuss about employee portal application with complete Ajax concept. Okay, so here we're gonna create employee, update employee, delete and read operations. So all the CRUD operations we're gonna perform with the server using an application called employee portal. So this application looks like this. We have employee portal and we have some a button and we have a table and update and delete. So let's make a design of this and then we'll start with the Ajax concepts. So first of all, I'll make my server ready. So go to the terminal. I was already running it, so I just stop that. Yeah, I have stopped it. So let's make npm start again. So it starts with the existing data, so it is started. Okay, fine. Now we need to create a folder structure for this. So for that I'll grab our copied folder. So the bootstrap structure I need, so I just copy this folder back to here. I'll paste it. So let's change this 03 underscore employee portal Ajax. Okay, and fine, we don't need console log. Let me go to index.html. so here I need a title employee portal Ajax. Okay, and let's make the same thing for my navbar, and let me open this in a live server. So close the existing application and refresh. So I have it. So this is our application. Yeah, here I need to use one backend API, that is our brain HTTP, the same Ajax library. So I need that. So I go back here, I copy this API folder and keep it in this folder, so because I want to use the same JavaScript file for this. Okay, so I just paste it, no changes in this. Okay, and fine. So first of all, we'll design the application and then start with calling Ajax and all. So let's make a design. So design looks like this. So we have employee portal and the button and all this. So let's start here. So employee portal intersection. So let's make one container, one row, single column. So here I need one H3. Let's take employee portal. Okay, and let's make some margin top 3. Okay, but it's very less font size. Let's make H1. Okay, looks good. Let's make H2. Fine. Below this, let's make p with the class called leader some huge content. So lorem 40 tab. Okay, and below that you need to have a button. So below this, let's create a button with the class called btn minus success, and let's make add employee. Okay, add employee button. Fine, but this heading looks very small. Let's make it H1. Okay, fine. So add employee button. So when I click on this, I need to open up model. We'll start with the model. After this, we need to have watch a table which contains all the data. So let's make a table now. So here employee table. So let's take a container. I write some margin top 3, one row, single column. Let's take a table. So I need here a bootstrap table. So I just give a class called table hover and table striped and table secondary and text center. okay, inside t head table row th star 7 tab, and some 7 columns. So first is employee ID and the first name, and then last name and email, gender and the IP address, and also I have a last one is actions. What are these actions is? You can make update and delete buttons for each particular row. Okay, and let's make the color of it t head with a class called lowercase bg dark and the text white. Check it out. Yeah, I got it. And below we need to have a table body, so t body. Okay, and this actually we have to display the content using JavaScript, so let's keep it as it is empty. And also let's make an ID table minus body. Okay, fine. One more thing is when you click on this employee, I need to open up an employee model. So let's start with the model once. So let's create a model now. Let's add a comment. So add employee model. And to create a bootstrap model. So how to write model. And let's make an ID. Add employee minus model. So let's make a connection between the button and the model. So that is data minus toggle is equal to data toggle is it's a model, and data target is gonna be the hash model. Okay, and then here we'll make model dialog. In this we need to have model content in this model header, and also model body. Let's check once. Yeah, we got it. And let's make the heading. Heading, I'll just write bg success text white. Here I write h3 add employee. Okay, and I need to have a cross symbol. Let's take a button with a class called close, and the data dismiss data is equal to model. Okay, when I click on a cross symbol, not came data button class close. Oh, I need to have a icon I tag with a class called fa minus times circle. Okay, so when I click on this, we got a cross symbol. When I click on that, it's closes. Okay, fine. In the model body, bg light. So let's make a light color background. Inside, we need to have a form data, right? So let's take a form. In this, I just take a division with a class called form group. In this input type is equal to text. The class called form control. So form group, form control, and let's make a placeholder. This is gonna be the first name. Okay, see once. Yes, I have first name, and same like this, I need to have multiple fields. So first name, last name, email, gender, IP address. Okay, so first name, 1 minute. This is gonna be the last name, and this is gonna be the email. So for email, type should be an email, and for gender, I don't need this. I need to make a select box. Let's take a select with a class called form control. Let's take an option. You can make an option value empty. Let's make a select gender. So first one is male, and the value goes to be male, and then I need female, and the value goes to be female, so that you'll get a select box. Yeah, looks good. Next, this one I need to make text box only IP address. So IP address, so check now IP address. Fine, so let's make a submit button as well. So I'll take a division with the input type is equal to submit, and the value goes to add employee with the class called btn minus success. Fine, anything else? Yeah, that's it. Okay, add employee to submit. And one more thing is, so each form data, each field data I need, so I need to have an IDs for each. So let's add something for the form. So add employee form. Okay, and for each input I'll just make an ID. This is add minus first name. Okay, so let's make it ID add minus last name, and here an ID add minus email, here an ID add minus gender. So finally this one is gonna be the add minus IP address. Okay, and anything else? Yeah, that's it. Yeah, let's also make some required field, because we are not performing any validation, so but I don't want to send empty data to the server, so let's make a default validation with HTML. So that's a required keyword, so required, everything is required now, so let's make it here required, here also required, this also required, so everything is required. Okay, so fine. So now what happened, when you click on submit, it asks for the field to enter, so it won't let you submit the empty form data. Okay, fine. This is finished now. So now one more thing is here, so whenever my application has been loaded, as soon as the page has been loaded, I need to display the form data. So when the page has been loaded, there is an event called DOM content loaded. If you want to know that, there is a specific event called DOM content loaded. Okay, so what this means is, if you go to the official DAOSIP documentation, see here, initial HTML document has completely loaded. Okay, then this event is gonna trigger. So let me attach that event like this. So whenever my application has successfully loaded, I need to send a GET request to the server, fetch data and display. So for that I'm gonna use this particular event. So how to attach the event is window.addEventListener and all this. So let's start. Back to app.js. Yeah, here DOM content loaded. So window dot add event listener of DOM. Spelling you must write properly. The spelling is gonna be this one, DOM content loaded, comma one function. Okay, so when DOM content is loaded, fetch data. So let's make fetch all employees, fetch all employees function I'm gonna call. Okay, so let me create this function. So let's fetch all employees is equal to a function. So this function has to fetch all the data from a Ajax, okay, using Ajax to the Node.js server. So but before you fetch, you need to load or import the brains HTTP module, but before that, if you're using modules concept, you have to modify the script to type module. So if you write type module, then only that module concept is accessible. Now let me import the brain HTTP here. import brain HTTP from the API. Okay, .js. Okay, so here let HTTP is equal to new brain HTTP. I create an object and let's make a get request. So get request again for this particular URL. So I'll just hard code the URL now, or else okay, let's hard code the URL. Or else let's make constant server URL is gonna be the up to API is my hard code URL copy. Okay, fine. Now here let URL is equal to let's make a backtick dollar server URL slash employees. Okay, this is my URL. So let's call upon the HTTP. So HTTP dot get, and here we need to provide the URL and the callback. So let's make our callback in like this. But this callback is giving two parameters. One is error and employees. So here error and employees. So let's make if any error. Let me just throw the error. Okay, so we'll fix this in the last. Okay, if no data, let me display some no data found on the page. Okay, if no records found, error message will display later. As I said, I'm just throwing error. But if no error, then display. So what you do is you have to let me check console log once. Okay, console.log of employees. So let me check the data, and then we'll loop it and display on a table. So console log. Fine. So go back here. Go to inspect and console. Yeah, you have an array of two records. Yes. As soon as the page loads, you got this AJAX request, get request data, and this data I want to display over here. So what I do is let's make a loop. So let employee rows is equal to empty, and for let employee of employees. Okay, for off loop, and here employee rows plus is equal to backtick. And here a table row slash table row, and let's make this format ID, first name, last name, email, gender, IP address, and two buttons here. So td, let's make a dollar employee dot ID. So like that, multiple things like a first underscore name, and this is last underscore name. This is gonna be the email, I think so. Yeah, gender, and finally the IP underscore address. Okay, but one more field is there, action. So what is that? Is we need to have two buttons, update and delete. So let's make out that as well. So td, in this I need to have two buttons. So let's add a button with a class called btn, btn minus, I think secondary button. Yeah, I think secondary or primary. Okay, secondary button. Let's make a update. Okay, and below I need to have another button, btn minus danger. This is actually a delete button. And let's also make some two other classes. One, this is update, and this is, I tell you why I'm writing these classes in a future concepts of this video, but let's keep it as it is. Fine. And also let's make a small button SM, and this is btn minus SM small button. Okay, fine. So finally this rows we have to inject to the watch table body. For table body we have an ID is watch table minus body. So quickly after this for loop finish, so document dot query selector of hash table minus body dot in a HTML, because HTML template it is. is equal to employee rows. Okay, done. So let's check. Yes, this is what I expect. Fine. But here actually, let's make some margin top. This is not properly aligned. Shall we make some margin top 0 or something? Okay, looks good. Fine. So we got data. So as soon as my application page loads, it's made a AJAX request to the server, Node.js server, fetch data and display. Fine. So this is what get request, read operation. So now what is pending is, if you click on add employee and to fill in details and click on add employee. So without refresh, it has to create a new employee over here. And then when I click on update, it actually has to open a model. So where you can update the fields, that one, and delete. So these three operations are pending. Okay, fine. So let's start with these operations in the next video. Thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe to my channel, and we'll meet in the next video. Thank you.